Yep. It's going to be one of those episodes today. Hello everybody, SuperWorld20 here, and today we're going to be going on an adventure in Kanto, in the land of Kanto, in Generation 1, Pokemon Yellow. Today what we're going to be doing is I'm going to start this video up in, back in Lavender Town, so we can actually... So I don't have to show that we've walked, like the distance of us walking here and back. Something that I'd done off screen is I leveled up our Pokemon. My Pokemon up a bit. I changed Mela and Char's to like the correct thing, and so Chupika's. I leveled up our Pokemon also. Chupika's level 27 now. And also you might see an inconsistency with the moves, because I was an idiot last episode and I accidentally turned off my system without saving. So, you might see a little bit of inconsistency. Also off-screen, I went and I dealt with, I dealt with all the, with the four guards that basically want their, want water. I dealt with that by just going into water. Be able to just, all that. So yeah, let's try to get into this part here. So let's get into this. Hey Wario, what brings you here? Your Pokemon don't look dead. I can at least make them faint. Let's go, pal. Okay. So we're going to be fighting a rival here, Albert. Call this a gym battle. I'll just call it. He's gonna send out a Fero. Because I personally don't know what. Okay, so he has a Fero, level 25, with the moves Mirror Move, Growl, Fury Attack. So, since this is an Ice type, we're going to be going out and use... We're going to use Ice Beam. It's going to be super effective, because it's a Flying type. Critical hit, super effective, it's dead. Okay, next Pokemon that he's going to be sending out... Okay, he's going to be sending out his Magmar. He's going to be sending out his Magmar. Excuse me for that silence. I was just looking at all my at my notes here, and there is a change that I should mention. Depending on what your opponent, what your person is going to be doing, his Eevee is going to evolve into different things. So if his Eevee evolves into Vaporeon, he's going to have a Vulpix, a Magmite, and an Eevee. If his Eevee is going to evolve into a Jolteon, he's going to have a Shellder instead of that Magmite. And if it's going to evolve into a Flareon, he's going to have... So let's do a cut. Okay. Smegmite has Sonic Boom Attack. All that this thing has, it's level 23. Nothing too much. Nothing too much. So yeah, how you guys been doing? I've been doing just fine. I've been dealing with some personal stuff. He's going to be sending out his Shellder. His Shellder has the moves. Why am I hesitating? God. His Shellder's level 23, with moves. Tackle, Supersonic, Clamp. So, good thing that we already have Sorai. Because we can... Okay. And Sorai is now level 27. Now he's going to be sending out a Sandshrew, level 20, Scratch, Sand Attack, and Slash. Let's send out Milin Char. Let's do a Mega Kick. We miss, obviously. He does a Sand Attack, but he fails. So let's pull off another kick. Gets to pull off his Sand. Our accuracy falls, but can we land another hit? Another Mega Kick? Nope. Sand Attack. We hit our Mega. Albert's about to use his Eevee. So... Okay. His Eevee. Level 26 with a move, 25 with the moves. Quick Attack, Tail Whip, Sand Attack, and Growl. Let's not switch out. I actually want to also go over, his potential full Pixies. So that roar can be a little bit hard to deal with, in my opinion. Floating enough. I'm a little bit in the competitive Pokemon scene. Just a little bit. I'm not the biggest competitive that I still try to dabble. Not really most. Let's send it, sent in Torpor so we can get a little bit more XP towards him. Attack. Bite. We miss. How are you missing? Pulls off another quick attack. Finish it off. And... What? You stinker. I took it easy. Got 1,060. Heard your Pokedex coming along, pal. I caught a Cubone. I can't find Grow Up Marowak, but I doubt there are any left. Well, I better get going. I got a lot to do. I have a lot to accomplish, pal. Smell you later. Okay. Yeah, we have a trainer here. No, we don't. Okay, yeah, so in the last episode, if you guys remember, I picked up the Sylph Scope. And that allows me to, see the dead. Okay. Pokemon. Escape rope. And okay, yeah, apparently we're on the third floor now. And I didn't realize it because I don't know how to count. So, this is a Ghastly, the, one of the two Pokemon that you can find on this floor in Pokemon Yellow. It goes at, levels that it can spawn at are 18 through 25 at 95% spawn rate. And hunters can also be found here at a 20 through 25 levels at a 5% spawn rate. it's only gonna do 20. Ghastly's, the ghost Pokemon were actually weak to psychic. All the ghost Pokemon in Generation 2, in Generation 1, were weak to psychic because they had that dual poison aspect to them. But, still, I really love poison type Pokemon. That is my favorite type of Pokemon just because the installing situations. And yeah, I need it. Yeah, let's do that right now. Let's also heal up Melantra. I have 6 super repels. Should help us out. So yeah. Now we're getting on to the the fourth floor. Pokemon that we can find here are more Ghastly and more Haunters. Everything is basically the same. Everything is the same. And So nothing too big of a deal. We have a mandatory fight here.
You curse with me, quack! Channeler wants.
Of course, then. Fired fights. Let's actually take Charmeleon out of there and let us put it. Put in Chupika. We haven't seen much to Chupika. I was actually personally contemplating whether or not I should just deal with all trainers here on off screen, but I thought of it. You also might see that moves kind of changed around a little bit. I no longer have Thunderbolt, and I have, Thunder Shock, and now I have Thunderbolt. And, yeah. Let's just get Milan Char back out there. Because this is just... Thank you. I'm gonna risk it. Ember, don't hit yourself. It hurt. Why did you? Seriously, this is like the only complaint that I do have about like the older generations is that they like rap. Seriously, that's. So, yeah, it's just, like, there weren't, like, you could do nothing against, like, Rat and Constrict, and it's just annoying. Yeah, it's just extremely good. Let's go for two. So, if you guys don't know what Nightshade is, it is a, move that actually, changes its power level, on what your level is. So, like, say if you're level 100, and you're fighting against, like, a level 1, you're gonna wreck. You're gonna wreck that Pidgey so hard. Does it. Because at that point, you would be damaged. Straight up, 100 damage. What? What? We found an elixir. Yay.